Lucy. It's so nice to meet you and to have the opportunity to hear more about this award-winning project. Congratulations on that. And also, this is an incredibly moving project. Can you tell us a little bit more about the Whitworth Art Gallery and the Still Parents Project?
Yeah, of course. So the Whitworth is an art gallery in Manchester in the UK, and it holds a kind of quite extensive collection of fine art, historic art, contemporary textiles and wallpaper. It's part of the University of Manchester, and it's quite unique in that it is situated within a park. So in 2015, we reopened after a big £15 million redevelopment. Wow. And it doubled the size of the gallery and sort of embraced the park that we're situated in. So it meant that we, there's lots of glass so that the outdoors can kind of come in and that you can kind of see what's inside from outside as well. So just kind of making the gallery more transparent, really. We call ourselves a constituent museum, which means that we work with partners, artists, community groups to use art for positive social change and to kind of use art to open up conversations and sort of actively address current issues. So things that are going on in the here and now. Mm-hmm. And Still Parents, which is the project I'm going to talk about today, is a really good example of a constituent project. It works with people and it kind of tackles current issues, really. So Still Parents is, like you say, an award-winning program that works with bereaved families. So families that have experienced the loss of a baby in pregnancy or just after birth. Mm. It was launched in 2019, so it's relatively new. And it's in partnership with a charity called SANS, who are, it stands for Stillbirth and Neonatal Death Charity. So they're our partners in the project, and we have established this project together over a couple of years, really, until we launched it in 2019. So we use art. We run art workshops for bereaved parents. And so we use the art, the art at the gallery, but also the act of making and doing to help people make sense of their experiences and to help them on their journeys and to just allow them to share their experiences through art, really.
This is incredible. It's just, I'm getting choked up just hearing you even talk about it. So how many families have participated in this program since it started?
Yeah, so we've had over 70 families that have sort of engaged in the sessions. We have a real range of people that drop in and out. We have people that come to just one session. We have people that have been to every session since we started. And we have a sort of core group of around 20 to 25 in a session. So they're quite big groups, really. And since we started in, when we launched the project in 2019, we had sold out the places within a day. There was obviously a real need for something like this. You know, I think we had 20 places and they were sold out within a day. And it really showed us that actually there isn't anything out there for bereaved parents. There's not enough support. And I personally experienced a stillbirth in 2016, which is where the project came from, really, is that I returned to work after a year and I sort of felt like it was a bit of a gift working in an art gallery. And these places are special. They're places that you can come and find respite and places that are just good for your well-being. And I kind of wanted to share the Whitworth and these sorts of places with others because it really helped me in my healing. And I really wanted other people to find these places to help them in their healing as well. So, it was kind of a very long process from when I sort of returned to work. And I just found that it was, when I had that experience, there wasn't anything out there. I wanted to meet other people that had been through similar experiences, but the only option was support groups, the sort of talk-based support groups. And actually that wasn't really what I wanted at that time. And so what I would have wanted is a way of sort of making sense of what happened through art and being creative. And so I kind of thought maybe this is an idea that we could run with and see if it had legs. And it seems like it is something that really resonates with people. It's something that people can do and make their experience, they can sort of make and do and make sense of their experiences, but in a quite productive way. Mm-hmm. And they can talk if they want to, but they don't have to. If they don't want to, they can just join the sessions and make and be creative with surrounded by other people that have had a similar experience to them, but not feel the pressure to have to talk about what's happened to them or what they've been through. And they can then go on a sort of journey through making. And we've seen a lot of the participants that have started off being quite reserved and have grown in confidence and grown through the process and are now very, very comfortable and confident and actually are helping those others that are now joining the sessions as newly bereaved parents. So it's a really nice sort of balance of people sort of working through the project and then new people constantly coming in that have had, you know, very new losses within the last few weeks that are seeing the progress and seeing the journeys that these others have been through in a way.
I love hearing that you're giving people the space to talk if that is their best mode of dealing with the grief, but also that there's something very tactile that they can process it in their own way and on their own time. And it's, I can't imagine going through that experience, but it seems as though it would be really great that those who have gone further through the process versus those that are coming in, they can actually be a support for one another in different ways that you would get in the talk therapy experience.
Yeah, it's a real support, you know, it's a support group, but in a completely different way to the typical support group. So it is through shared experience. It's through being in a room with other people that have experienced the same as you. And you sort of have this unwritten bond, you know, you have this bond with each other, even though you don't need to talk about it. Mm-hmm. And you're right, that the process of making and doing in the sessions is cathartic. You know, that we do embroidery, we do drawing, and people can lose themselves in that moment and think about their babies, but also forget in a way as well. So it's just it's very much about the process of making rather than about, you know, what we're creating and the product. Yeah. It's just about coming together and making together, chatting or not chatting, depending on how you're feeling that day.
So are your participants primarily the parents, or is it also siblings or combination?
Yeah, so it's mainly parents, yeah. So it's couples or single people that come along. So a real mix. So we get mainly females, but quite a few males that come along as well. It's just a really nice, I think those that have come as couples have found it a really good way of opening up conversations between them as couples, because mm-hmm. going through a loss like this can really put a lot of strain on relationships. And actually I feel like the sessions and the workshops and the art can really help to open up conversations and to really help people to understand each other and where they are and where they're at in their journeys of grief. And it just finds an outlet for their grief that allows them to share. Mm-hmm.
So I imagine this is a lot for all of you who facilitate this experience? And what kind of preparatory work have you as the facilitators had to put together, both emotionally as well as, I don't know, therapy work, or, you know, I don't know exactly what it would be, but is there anything in particular for like other organizations that they did something that things that you would recommend for?
Yeah, I think what's key to this project is the partnership with SANS. I think that's really important to sort of go into this with a charity or an organisation that have experience of, you know, these sorts of happenings. It was helpful that I'd been through the experience myself as well. So there's an understanding there. And even when people send that initial email, I think having somebody that responds, that knows how to respond, is quite unique and quite key, really, because there's a certain way that people want to be responded to, and it's acknowledging their babies and acknowledging that their loss, and perhaps asking the name of their baby, or, you know, what gender they had, and just understanding that they're really important questions to ask in these specific situations. And what's interesting for this project is that we have a really nice team, which is, I work in the civic engagement and education department within the Whitworth, but we also have a curator on the project as well, and Sam's working on the project. And between us, we've all had experience of loss. In very different ways, we've had very different experiences, and I think that really helps us to shape the sessions, because I think we're all coming at it from different angles, but with that shared knowledge and that shared experience as well. So we haven't had training per se, but we have had personal experience of baby loss, which I think makes this project quite unique.
Yeah, I can't even imagine how invaluable that would be to be able to bring that. And it's really great that you all have experiences that you can share and help support one another as you go through that.
Yeah. I think that's key, is definitely supporting each other, and it being a really, you know, a really amazing community that comes together through that shared experience.
So, can you briefly describe like a workshop, what that might entail? And like, is it a several week workshop, or is it just a one day? What does that kind of look like for the participants?
Yeah, so the workshops take place once a month, and they are 2.5 hours long, and we do them in the evenings so that people can work and still come to them, and can put children to bed if they've got children, and then engage in them. So we do them 7 until 9:30. It's typically very practical. So the session is always inspired by something from the Whitworth collection. So that might be an exhibition that's on, or an artwork that we have in our collection as the inspiration. And then we kind of use that as a springboard for the practical activities. So we've done all sorts. We've done photography, we've done lino printing, we've done embroidery, we've done watercolour painting, we're doing clay coming up. So that we just sort of wanted to give participants a real breadth of experience, mm-hmm. so that they could try something out. And then if they found it useful and found it helpful and enjoyed it, they could then go and sort of take that further in their own time, but that we're sort of giving them these little tasters and these little ways that they might use to sort of make sense of their experiences and to use as a sort of outlet for their grief. So there's been participants, for example, in the watercolour workshop that were quite sort of hesitant and thinking, oh, this isn't for me, really, I'm not arty, but that have really responded well to that particular medium and have actually wanted to continue and do more along that route. And so it's been nice to see people kind of taking things on in their own times and sort of seeing projects that happening in between sessions.
I love that you're offering a variety of mediums for them to work with, because as you said, everyone responds different mediums in different ways. So that's really great.
And I think even if people don't think it's for them, I think the fact that they're willing to have a go, mm-hmm. and we very much put across that it's not about the product. It's not about what you create. It's just about the process and enjoying the moment. And, you know, we've done drawing workshops and, you know, people are very, very afraid of drawing often because they've had bad experiences at school or they've just not drawn for years and years and years. And so we very much push that it's that you don't even need to show anybody what you're making, what you're drawing. It's just about you and your moment and your experience. And if you want to share it, that's great, but there's no pressure from us to have to sort of produce something at the end of the session.
My final question for you, is there a particular family that has really stood out to you that just in the way they processed everything or what they created that has just touched you personally?
Yes. But I think what's really apparent in these sessions is that feeling of a community and of it not really being about individual stories, but about being about a shared experience. So everybody sort of bringing their own experiences, but that it's finding the sort of the common connections and the common ground, because everybody's had their own experiences, had very different experiences. But what's interesting about this project is there really is a sort of bond between people. And yes, there's been some real magic moments of, in particular, a couple that have been coming since November. So they started in November of 2019. And as a couple, they've been to every single session since. And they came within weeks of losing their baby. And you can see the pain, you know, you can see the pain in them when they start these sessions. And we've been going for 18 months now. And we've just seen such a huge, huge difference in them, their confidence and their relationship together. And also, they've gone on to have another baby together, and we've been able to share that joy and that celebration as a group. And it's sort of, and when people go on to have other babies, it really brings a sense of hope for the rest of the group that they will also go on and have successful pregnancies. And so they've been on such a huge journey over the 18 months, and I feel like we've been on that journey with them because we've been with them from the very beginning. So you do create these quite special relationships with people, really, that you've seen them grow and you've seen them change over time, and hopefully we'll be able to continue to see them and see them and their baby grow for you know, time to come.
Oh, that's so lovely. Well, congratulations again on your award. This is an amazing, emotional, and a very healing program, obviously. So thank you, and be safe.
Thank you very much.